The first impression that comes to our mind about any college: tall buildings, big classrooms, large lobby areas, thick books, IT labs, assignments, class tests, and projects. Nothing besides that. Every hour, minute, second spent here help us carving and shaping our persona, cultivating innovative mindsets for the challenging world. Learning is a lifelong process. Sharing knowledge, inculcating values of life, spark the innovative horizons of mind. Fun and frolic is the nature of every nook and corner here. A daily dose of thrill we are sure to get here.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Krishna Pandey, convener of Training and Placement Cell, DMV Media School, and I welcome you all to this interactive session with senior management team of Fandrum, organized by DMV Placement Cell in association with DMV Media School and DMV Management School. The Training and Placement Cell DME acts as an interface between the industry and the academia by facilitating professional opportunities for students and organizing guest lectures and special sessions with industry experts and senior media educators. As a part of industry interface, today we are organizing this interactive session, and I hope students will make the most of this session. So now I request Abhishek Mishra to take the session forward. Abhishek.
Thank you, Baba. I would now like to take a moment and introduce Delhi-Metropolitan Education. Delhi-Metropolitan Education is an eight-grade premier education institute affiliated to Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University, New Delhi, and approved by the Bar Council of India. The institute offers DBA, BA and BBLLB and BAJMC programs. DME believes in imparting world-class education to its students by training them to develop and enhance their skills. This education and training enables them in taking up challenges of the industry and creating a space for themselves with their competence and vigor. Fandrum, an app poised to become the world's first fan tech platform, is meant to connect with fans and stars and artists and vice versa. It is a unique media tech platform focused on fan engagement and analytics. It also provides a platform where fans unite to make their fandom most unique in the universe of fandoms. Now, I invite Professor Dr. Ambreet Saxena, Dean, DME Media School, to please say a few words.
Thank you, Abhishek. So it's a matter of pleasure that such a session is being organized for the students. And I believe that the students of media and the management studies both would have joined this session as it was planned, because the basic objective was to bring to the students all those possibilities, all those opportunities which they normally are always looking for. And talking about Fandrum, it's a completely new idea. And in this technology age, what is the most important thing is all about the ideas. Once you have an idea, then obviously you can work for the execution of that idea. So obviously execution is equally important, but then the idea is important. And if you have any such out of the box idea, which nobody would have ever thought before you, so obviously you will always take a lead. So that is how I congratulate the team of Fandrum to bringing this kind of idea and to working so hard to implement this, to execute this. And this is again remarkable in the sense that this is something which is directly related to the youth. We are living in an age where in the entertainment becomes the most important part of our life, or rather everybody's life. It's not that only young people need entertainment. People of any age would need entertainment. And particularly during this pandemic, this COVID-19 has changed the scenario completely. And there are so many avenues of entertainment. And in entertainment, there are people who we always look at. There are people who we continuously watch on the big screen or on the small screen. We develop some kind of fascination for those people. And as media put it, all such people in the category of the celebrities. So in this kind of culture, wherein every common person, every viewer, every media person is looking at these people who are in that category of the celebrity. So this is one platform which is linking a common person, the youth, to those celebrities, and this also brings job opportunities to the young people. So that is how we invited the young team of Fandrum to talk to our students, tell them what all this app is about, what kind of openings are there for the students in this Fandrum, and then whatever interaction follows, and if there are certain queries by the students, so those queries will definitely be answered. So I welcome Samriddhi and her team, who all are there in this session, and we are looking forward to having an enlightening and interesting session. Thank you all.
Thank you for your wise words, sir.
Thank you so much, Amri sir.
Thank you.
So with this, let's move on to our interactive session. The session will be followed by a question and answer session moderated by Mr. Mohit Kishore Vats. I'd like to request the audience to post their questions in the chat box. Now I'd like to invite Mr. Gaurav Barjatya, mentor of Fandrum marketing leader, to address us.
Thank you, Devishri. Thank you, everybody. It's very interesting that this entire interaction session is happening now when, you know, there's so much happening in the world of media. There's so much happening in the world of startups. Like every day, you hear about new companies, new IPO, somebody launching something new, somebody becoming unicorn. So this is absolute, you know, there's no going back from here. There will be new age industries that are going to take over the services sector. And potentially in the country's GDP, you'll see the contribution going up. So, you know, I think this is a great opportunity for all the students here to understand what the future lies and to be ready for it. As much as I'm sure DME is setting you up for success in the future, there are a few things that, you know, I possibly would be able to give you as my mantras that has sort of helped me. So I come with extensive comes to marketing, right? Marketing is about telling people about the product. It's about telling people about the company. It's telling people about what we want to do. No, it is not. Marketeers, people who are running, important is to listen to your customers, listen to your viewers, listen to your fans. Be the voice of the fans to the company, then trying to be the voice of the company to the fans. The moment you change that, you know, lens, you'll see your entire vision change. And, if you role that your viewers, your fans, your consumers, your customers will play in your success, in your company's success, that will give you a deep understanding of them to begin with. Right, because it's war fans for people who are giving them a world of content, a world of entertainment, a world of characters, a world of escapism. Right, fans have always invested themselves behind stars and content, but they've sort of never been recognized. Of course, you have influencers now, that space has become really big, but influencers are technically again people who are somewhere between the celebrity and the fans. They almost become like a trading unit who will further engage with the fans. They're not the fans themselves. So, you know, what the team has set up here in terms of Fandrum is an opportunity to celebrate fans, is an opportunity to recognize fans, an opportunity to give them an experience that nobody else is giving them for being a loyal fan to the brand and the storytelling. Right, so it's a merge of a lot of things that puts fan in the center and gives opportunity to the brands to engage with the fans directly and firsthand. From marketing perspective, it's a absolutely, you know, like an open sky. There is nothing that sort of restricts the opportunity at hand. There is no limitation in terms of what this platform can become in the future, because everybody wants a pie of that fan. Everybody's struggling for that. But the struggle that companies think through is mostly about money, not about the emotional investment that the fan has made, right? When I talk about fan and when you listen about fans, they're not some, you know, different species, right? I can see there are, you know, over 100 people on the call, and I can, you know, bet my life to say that all 100 would be fan of somebody or something, right? There's nobody who's not a fan of a movie or a superstar, a story. It could be any basic thing, right? So put yourself in the shoes of that fan and think about all the emotional investments that you've done, right? And you have not been given that opportunity to be celebrated. This is an opportunity to that fan, to that core fan, right? And I think I would not delve into the platform, you know, more. I would let Samriddhi talk about the platform and the entire backend. But from the, you know, from pure consumer perspective, marketing perspective, from people who are going to be running the business of, you know, brands in the country going forward, please remember, okay? I also understand that DME also is in journalism and law. If there are any journalism and law students, please disregard my mantra. If you are a lawyer in making, please do not hear. There, the objective is to get your point across and not take somebody's point on board. So just keep that in mind, right? I'll pass this, you know, stage to Samriddhi. I think she would be a better person to talk about the platform further. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, Gaurav.
Thanks.
So next, we have the founder and chief product officer of Fandom, Mr. Vipul Chaube, who has been working in the film and television industry since 2006 in various capacities. He has moved from the production vertical to the creative vertical over the years, and this gives him a greater insight into the problems that sometimes producers face when executive vision. A go-getter by attitude. I'd like to invite Vipul sir to say a few words.
Am I audible?
Yes, you are.
Hi, everybody. So welcome. Thanks for joining. We'll be showcasing Fandom to you guys. And after a year of going through the platform, it has finally turned up. Hopefully you guys will like it. So the idea behind the platform being that as regards all the social media platforms that exist as of today, they're all about you. In the sense that they reflect you, that is you, your age, your name, your demographic, your location, etc. So they're kind of an extension of yourself into the virtual world. What we do here is we are talking about you, about yourself. That is who, what kind of person you are, what kind of characters you like, what is your inclination towards various truths, various false fallacies, various tropes, various archetypes, etc.
Mr. Vipul, sorry I'm interrupting. Is there any possibility if you can turn on your camera? Is that possible, sir?
He's traveling right now, as I mentioned before.
Yes. Okay. Fine.
Sorry about that.
And that would actually kill my network. And coming back to Fandom, so Samriddhi, will you first take them through the presentation?
Yeah, you know, I will take you guys through what Fandom is in a little brief, and then Vipul and I together will show you the app itself, right? So that you know that we have done justice to what we were thinking. First of all, I would really, really like to thank Amrish sir and team and Bala ma'am and Mohit for coordinating all of this. Mohit, I know I've been tough, but thank you for the patience that you've shown towards me. And thank you all the students for coming on and listening to us. I believe it's a great opportunity. When I was in college, we were looking for opportunities and we had to find our own way. But with Amrish sir on your side, he's letting opportunities flow your way, right? So thank you again for inviting us and helping us do this. So quickly coming on to the point of what Fandrum is a platform simply about celebrating fan, you know, a place where you belong. I'll quickly introduce who we are. It's me, Samriddhi, Vipul, Arkiran CTO. I don't know how many guys know Lavranjan, who is the director of Pyar Ka Panchnama and Sonu Ki Titu Ki Sweetie. His next film is with Ranbir Kapoor and Shraddha Kapoor. He's also making the remake of Saurav Ganguly biopic, right? So he's the third founder with us. And we would love to help you guys, introduce you to him, intern with him and everything, and be on our app. Because he is very, very integral part of our system. And then people who are in South, we have a guy called Sanjay Reddy. He is like a veteran of South India industry, with launching all the channels in South, and currently owns a very, very big entertainment channel. So going further, so we are a tech platform. We have filed for two patents, which are literally patent pending, one in the reward field, one in the psychology field, one in the psychographic field. So we call ourselves as the world's first social media platform where an entire broadcast ecosystem can come together, you know, from both consumer side, fan side, viewer side, audience side, to content producers, to broadcasters, to advertisers, to brands, and to celebrities, all commonly benefiting from one platform. So everybody, you must have heard as media students that content is king. However, in Fandrum, we really believe if content is the king, fan is definitely the king gong. Because fan is the person who makes the content the king. Whatever he chooses or he likes becomes the king, right? So here, fan is at the center of the universe of the content. Quickly understanding what separates fans from audience from fans, right? So a casual viewer is very passive, has barely any engagement, is the receiver, is not willing to spend, does not contribute, right? Whereas a dedicated fan is very active, very emotional evangelist, spends money, advocates, talks to his friends, spreads word of mouth, spends his own time and money, is very, very involved in the content that he's watching. It's like being in a relationship with the content when you're watching. You know, you want to really talk about it, you feel proud of it, and you want to go and talk about it to everywhere. He has a highly repeat value and is willing to invest in experiences. So here in this platform, what we want to do is get everybody as a viewer and through his dedication and through his engagement, identify him and through the process, reward him through the journey. Because that is the missing link between our Fandrum. We are very, very scared. We are language agnostic. We are replicable in the sense we can go into any language very, very quickly. We just have to add language and we can scale up globally. The idea is we are using two fundamental things to make our platform very, very unique from all the other platforms that exist in social media. Firstly, we are using the best of technology, which everybody claims to be using. The second thing that we are using is the psychographic analysis of a content watching person. What we mean by a psychoanalysis of the person is, like, right now the data that Bach gives or the data that we have of a content watching person is a very demographic data. The age, the place, the female, just the gender part. That's the only, Varav, correct me if I'm wrong, right? Right now as a marketer, you only get this kind of data, right? Age, sex, gender, and place and location where you're born from. But here So here what we are trying to do differently is we are trying to understand what your content choices are by grouping you to the similar people who like the similar kind of content. We have a very, very unique onboarding system which will actually help you identify yourself, that which kind of content, which kind of characters resonate more with you, and help you then recommend content based on your liking and understanding, and putting you in a community of the like-minded people and then rewarding you for it, right? So here everybody joins as an audience, becomes a fan, and then becomes an influencer. We are a community first platform. As I mentioned, that the community is the essence. You don't have to be necessarily a fan of Shah Rukh Khan. You can be a fan of Raj, you can be a fan of Rahul, you can be a fan of Kabir Singh, you can be a fan of Chak De, you can be a fan of Tiger with the brand he supports, you can be a fan of KKR. You can be a fan of all these things, but have something in common, which is Shah Rukh Khan, right? So there will be an umbrella fandom of Shah Rukh Khan in which all the community of like-minded people can interact. It has never been done by any 25,000 movies and 39 OTTs. This is, and we will be able to recommend you your next best choice of content. The idea is to recommend you in less than a minute. Now we'll talk about what kind of rewards we're trying to give. So let's first, so like Facebook or any other social media, LinkedIn, Twitter, wherever you go, there is like, comment and share that you do generally, right? Here for every call for action, whether it is like, comment, share, amplify, there is a point system and the points get generated for you. Those points can be then redeemed for a reward. The rewards are very, very exciting. First, before going to what kind of rewards we are talking about, we went all around the globe to understand what the industry is talking about, right? Including who was very, very essential to help us driving what the importance of this is. Media companies are only focused on developing audience, but it's no longer enough. At Turner, we are focusing all our efforts in getting to the fans, which is the most valuable type of customer. Fans, those 25, you know, there is an 80-20 principle in every economics, right? So those 20% of the people drive 70% of the value, and those 20% of the people drive 80% of the franchise value. That's how important it is to differentiate between an audience and a fan. Networks are looking for more than casual viewers. They are looking for dedicated fans. Fans are evangelizers, advocates, and are willing to express in experiences. The biggest differentiation, the pattern is a very, very big analyst in the media and entertainment industry. She says it's a mix of art, science, and data-driven decision-making that helps create fans and the rewards that also drive revenue. That's where we realize we are really on the right track to build something big. So what kind of rewards are we talking about, right? Experiences that money just can't buy. You may have a lot of money, but you can buy a visit to film fair, or you can do anything. But what about the people who are in the tier two, tier three cities who do not get recognized as fans? Gaurav, yesterday when we were having a conversation, said something about everybody has a similar right in constitution, right? If a killer is a rich guy or a poor guy, the punishment is the same. Similarly, right, for the fan, whether you are a rich fan or a poor fan, the reward for you should be the same. So here becomes a level playing field for every fan to get each kind of an opportunity to be themselves. Whether it is meeting Amitabh Bachchan, whether it is going to Kapil Sharma show, whether it is celebrating your birthday, whether we send you to Filmfare in the most exclusive format, or whether we send you to Big Boss or any other dance reality show. The other 10,000 other rewards for instant gratification are, we give you subscriptions, right, for the biggest OTTs that you want to watch. We give you meets and greets, like you can chat with your favorite character. We have tied up with Sony, we have tied up with AHA, we have tied up with a lot of OTT platforms and all to help give you all these kinds of experiences. So there are a lot of fan apps that exist in the market which are only based on a transactional band and have no emotional equity. There are places like Facebook and Friends and Twitter, you might ask that we can do this here. But these fan groups exist and are scattered, and your voice is barely heard. You know, you are not recognized. Your voice is not heard even by the broadcaster or with your friend. So this is in a nutshell what we are trying to do. India, though, this is a very important thing that I missed. So 80% of the people while watching content use the smartphone while watching the content, right? All we are trying to do is bring India's two favorite screens together. So this is in a nutshell what we are trying to do. We have done a lot of partnerships so once we begin, we will have 469 TV channels, 25,000 movies, 39 OT channels for you to discover from, 5 languages, which is Malayalam, Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, and English. And sir, Amrisa, last year when we curated the fan video, these are the 10,000 fan videos that we curated last year with DME students during internship will be available for you guys to see on the platform. So we have tied up with Lavranjan Films, we have tied up with Vasu Bhagnani Films, which is coming up with the 10 biggest films of the year next year. We have tied up with the biggest South Indian films, which is Prabhas and everybody coming in the next couple of years to be their fan partners. So yes, the scope of being a fan or a fan partner is huge. And we have an exclusive tie-up in the South, you know, an exclusive tie-up with Love Films, an exclusive tie-up with Pooja Films. And the idea is to send fans to all these locations to help you guys get training in all these fields and help you these guys come and mentor you on these platforms, right? We have also tied up, so these channels that we are already with us have 66 million subscriptions. So we'll be targeting these people in the coming 3 years to get our first million users on the platform. These are the celebrities that are already endorsing us.
Hi guys.
Hi guys, thank you so much for all the love and support.
Hello, hi, Pranam Alekum.
Hey guys, this is Manjali Parmis.
Now, what are you doing? You are a little bit of a little bit of a little bit
of a little bit of a little bit of a little
bit of a little bit of a little bit of a little bit of a little bit of a little bit of a little bit of a little bit of a little bit of a little bit of a little bit of a little bit of a little bit of a little bit of a little bit of a little bit
that there is a new way you and I can communicate.
It's one of the first media platforms exclusively for fans and celebrities to interact, to engage,
create content, start a conversation.
So let's catch up on Fandrum.
Let's catch up on Fandrum.
Download the app right now.
Fandrum Co. Download TJ.
So join Fandrum and get a chance to meet your stars.
So make sure you download Fandrum right now.
Download Fandrum.
So besides these, we have onboarded a lot more regional celebrities and all. So yes, the last 1 year that we were making the platform has been all going about doing the tie-ups and making our app. Now I will just invite Vipul to share the app and see how it looks like. Vipul, it's over to you, sir.
I think in the meanwhile, Samriddhi, if you can brief our students, although you have shared that document, that PowerPoint presentation, which talks about the kind of job description, yes, which requires to join your company. But there are certain students here who are from digital media marketing background. There are certain students who are from management school as well. So if you can please brief us the kind of job requirements or the JD for this particular job, I think that would be great for the students.
So thank you, Mohit. Yes, the idea is to first let you guys use the app for the first couple of weeks and see your feedbacks and how you like and get your feedbacks towards us. And then we will select students who would like to intern with us. Then we will give the students paid internship for the next 3 months. And students who perform the best will be hired. We have 10 students that we're looking to hire in the next round. Digital marketing students, MBA students, and students, it doesn't matter on the degree, you know, until unless you are passionate and you have a reason that you would like to join the platform. In Star, it was never about who had what particular degree. It was about the passion that the person shared and the disruption that somebody could bring in while doing this, right? I have no background. I had no background in technology or anything, yet we decided to make a tech app, right? Everything else falls in place. I think Gaurav would agree more that the more passionate you are about, the more you love about something, if you fall in love with the app, there are a thousand ways you can be associated with the app or the industry, right? And the idea is also to help you guys across the industry, to help you place people, to help place people wherever they are needed. So the idea is that we are looking for students, for digital marketing students who can help create content for us, who can help maintain our social media platforms, who can help create virality around those contents, you know, who can help drive people or make people recognize that, yes, here is a platform for fans which you can join, who can spread the virality around, who basically know how you guys are more young, who you guys use more social networking probably more than us, right? So what is the differentiator that you can promote that, use differentiated? See, if everybody has money, you know, you can obviously go and use SEOs and other marketing tools and spend money and promote yourself. But we will obviously be doing that. But here is a platform for you to create content, GIFs and everything and promote it through social media. And people with the highest reach and highest everything will get to be a part of Fandrum, you know, who comes up with disruptive ways to market, disruptive way to channel the resources that we have. So there are four different segregated job profiles that I've already shared with Mohit and the team that he will probably share with you that we are looking for. But first, the idea is 2 weeks. You guys use the platform as much as you can. then whoever is interested can come back to us and say, we are interested in joining the internship. Use it from his phone, na?
I think in the meanwhile, we are figuring out this issue. Pramod sir has also joined this session and he's also recording this session. So I would also like him to pose certain questions as part of digital media marketing. I and Pramod sir will be posing certain questions to you. You have just described the kind of job requirements which a student must have for joining this particular app. So Pramod sir, if you have any questions, you can also go ahead and we can both manage this question and answer session.
Thank you very much, Mohit sir. Good afternoon, Samriti ma'am. Well, actually, when we were discussing in the class, when we were telling them about the idea of Fandrum, because last year also we attended the session that was held by you. So we were telling the students and they were very fascinated by this idea of a platform where, you know, the celebrities and the fans and, you know, everyone is coming together. So they were very fascinated by this idea and they had this question in mind that, how did you manage to come up with this idea, first of all? And what were the apprehensions initially? How did you manage to rope in the celebrities? Because, you know, celebrities have so many platforms where they can interact with fans if they want. And that is the kind of power that the celebrities possess. But how did you manage to convince them? How did you think about the, you know, financial aspects of the entire platform? And what were the challenges and how you went about it? If you could just, you know, tell the students, they would be very inspired. You know, probably, you know, they would also want to do some kind of a startup, take up some startup initiative in future.
And, you have asked a lot of questions in one question. So I'll try and answer one at a time. Where did we come up with this whole idea, right? See, being in the media entertainment system, I was not a person who was an MBA, or I was just sitting in the boardroom listening to people like Gaurav and all the other Gaurav's talk about research and numbers and everything, you know. The more we sat in the conversations, the more I realized that all the conversations and all the numbers are driven around audience, you know. But, and also in that meetings, we used to talk about our core audience, which is the 25% that matters to us a lot. So my question to myself every single time was that, why is not that we are focusing only on that 25%? And why do we keep focusing on the 100% of data, right? Why are we not targeting those 25%? And if we have to target, which is the platform, you know, that will help target us, help us with that. This was the first thing where we differentiated between audience and fan, right? That there has to be a segregation between audience and fan. The second bigger aspect was that while we were doing this for last couple of years, we sent a lot of people on these shows, you know, because we had this media background and we had this access to a lot of these shows and everything. We realized people from all over the world, whether it was UK, US, or all around from India, used to come and visit these sets. And all we had to give them was the access. You know, this is how bigger the celebrities are and how big these fans are to meet. It's just about providing the access. The third very important factor is that If you talk about a celebrity, what makes a celebrity? The fan followers, right? One day you remove all the fan followers, who is the celebrity then? The fan is the celebrity, right? So you give fan more power of doing everything, right? So here we decide, we just told celebrities that if you are about what you are saying, that you are because of your fan, then show that fandom, show that respect to the fan, right? Here is a platform that is trying to celebrate the fans that are for you. We are making your fandoms, combined fandoms, and here you can be, right? So it was, all the celebrities were more than willing, all the directors, all the producers were more than willing to celebrate these fandoms, right? The second question being financial, it's a very, very tough journey. You know, you have to give in your heart, soul, every penny of what you have earned to dedicate this. It's not about the money, but if you have the passion and the drive, you will go through it. No matter whether you are at the last of the 100 rupees that you need in your bank account, whether you have the 1 crore, money doesn't solve the problem. It's the people, it's the passion, it's the team that helps you solve the problem. And the more passionate you are about something, and I think Gaurav will talk more about that because he's handled much bigger teams at a much larger scale and entire channels to deal with. I think the biggest thing is the passion that you can bring to anything that you do. And if you define your passion and the thing that you love, then you will work day and night for doing that, you know. But I would really want you to expand a little bit more on this.
I'll just add one point, Samriddhi, and you said it right, and I just want to make sure that all the students here on the call understand that please chase the passion, do what you love, right? Because nobody ever changed the world because they wanted to get rich. They changed the world because they believed in something. They wanted to do something. They had a dream. They had passion, right? So don't go after the money. Money will eventually follow. Do what you love. Do what you, feel passionate about. Eventually, you will find success. If you do something for the sake of money, it's just about time when you'll run out of the love for it. Or maybe that money will start looking less. And then you'll again start chasing the bigger money. So, it's a rut. So you have to find the passion, that thing that drives you. I mean, you can have different words for it. Somebody say, I find my mojo here. Somebody says I find my passion here. Somebody's got dreams. Somebody's got ambition. But it all boils down to the same thing. Don't chase anything for the wrong reason. Find the right reason and then, throw your kitchen sink behind it. Then go all out. Then don't hold yourself back. I mean, a lot of people do that mistake where they feel passionately about something, but then they start feeling slightly, scared. There's a fear. Don't hold yourself back. I mean, that would be the biggest mistake that you'll regret 20, 30, 40 years down the line, saying that if I would have taken that decision, I would have been doing something that I really, enjoy, something that I can talk about, something, those stories that I'll tell my kids, my family, my grandchildren about, always go for those stories.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much. It was very well answered. Sure. There's just one question. There's a student is asking that if he wants to download this particular app, where is it available?
We will be sharing link with you guys. People with Android can share. You can share your email IDs, and people with Android phones right now, because we are only Android right now. We will give you access to the app, and you will be able to download the app. And the app is not, the link is not working, but I'm sure you guys can see my screen from here if you do do this, right? Can we do this way just quickly, right? So this is a home screen that the fan looks like. You open the app, you directly get, there is a whole onboarding process that you will have to go through. It will be an onboarding like Tinder, You swipe right for the character, or first you will be able to select a language. Then you will be asked, you will be shown characters based that language, right? You will be shown, if you swipe right for a character, you will be actor, you will be shown a lot of characters of that actor. You can pick and choose, then you can swipe right, swipe left, then there will be a skip button, and then it will get you to this feed. So maybe I've chosen Ajay Devgan and all these people, these becomes my fandom, right? And all the friends that I have, I keep seeing fandom pages. Here is a discovery part, whatever new movies have come, and whatever new things are available for us to see will be available for you to see right on the app itself. And the videos last time that you guys created, the fan videos, you will be able to see on the next screen. Like if I want to see the fan video, there'll be all the fan videos of that particular thing be available to see. Now reward function is yet not working. That's why we haven't uploaded it on the Android. By this weekend, all the rewards will be uploaded. So you guys will also have the access to rewards. So please go and redeem your rewards. So there will be a chat feature where we will suggest you friends and everything based on your content liking, based on your everything. Here will come suggested friends who have common fandoms, right? You can have one-on-one chat. You can have one-on-one chat with all these people. And here will be your profile page where you can make your profile. You can choose your languages. You can change your settings. You can do everything. So once you guys go and explore the app, we will share the app link with you and you can download the app. Mohit sir, I only require one thing. Just share the email IDs and the mobile handset ID, mobile handset, Samsung or OnePlus or whatever, with that and student's name, and we'll share the link. You can share the link with everyone.
Okay. 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 Ma'am. Will that be possible if For example, if I send you my email ID and then you can send me the link and I can forward it to
Have to upload the we have to give prior permissions to the kid for them to download. So I will have to add all their IDs, whoever wants to, and then they get, then we will share the link that these people can download. So it's in a beta version right now. That's why it's not allowed to go. But from next week, if we finish after these students finish their exams, it'll be available for all Android people to download. I have just one question from you, Mohit sir. When do you think these people can start with the internship and give their feedbacks and everything? Will there be a date or anything?
I think, ma'am, we have here in the audience, we have fifth semester students, that is digital media marketing. So most probably they will be completing their examinations in the month of first week of December. So probably they can join at that point of time. If they want to join now, they can probably join after
first
the classes.
December, they will finish exams.
Yeah, but external exams. The semester is going to conclude in the first week of December. So right. They may join formally from that point of time. But right now, if they want to join, they can join after the classes.
Okay. And all the other students who want to be a part of internship can join anyways, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So please, I would request DME to students to all download the app, give us your feedback, because you will be the first guys to have access of the app. We will create history together. That's the idea. And the more feedbacks we get, the more valuable feedback, we will choose people from those feedbacks to come and intern with us, to come and be a part of this journey. That's all I have to say. So 100 students have joined. You can probably circulate to everybody, whoever wants to join and download the app. And everybody is more than happy to come and start using the app. Mohit, we will make you meet your favorite celebrity also.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Actually, we already have another event. Soumya is a student of management school and Seema ma'am is also here. So management school is also having an event at 3:00. So hence the audience is divided into two events. Hence we could not get that target. But no. Yes, I'll definitely circulate this information. I have already circulated that information. But due to this paucity of time and two events falling on one day, hence the audience was divided.
No problem, sir. Thank you.
There is just one thing, ma'am, that I would want to ask you. That's the last question. Because we have been interacting with the students and telling them about this opportunity of internship and then, you know, possible absorbing, you know, in the job. Yeah. So like, if you can just tell what kind of, things that the students will do so that they can be mentally prepared, probably they can give it a thought. If you can tell just well in advance what kind of, you know, content they would need to prepare, and you know, if you could just give that much description, that would be very helpful for the students.
I think the voice is cracking. What Pramod sir is wanting to ask, ma'am, is about the kind of job responsibilities and the kind of skills that that you would require them to have so that they can be mentally prepared for joining this internship.
One job responsibility for us to figure out what does youth want, how do they want this message to be communicated that there are fans, and how can this message go viral. This is what students have to do, you know, help us understand them, help us understand what students like, help us understand their passion, their liking, their needs, so that we can tell this to the world. And I keep emphasizing on the word passion. There is no skill set. Every skill set is developed, you know. 2-5 years down the line, we may not even have these courses because the world may have changed, right? Is what you have to discover for yourself. Digital marketing is a very, very important space. I'm sure you guys have learned enough how to, the basic fundamentals of digital market. Apply that in practical life right now here. That's the fundamental, right?
I think you have very well answered the question. I think we are done with the question and answer session, and we are definitely going to circulate this information about this app and the other things that you have shared with me with the students. Another question before actually concluding this session, I've just got this question in the chat box. It's a difficult kind of a question to answer at this point. She's asking, one of the student is asking that on what basis one can be recruited for the internship. I think you just answered the question.
Talk about that, how much you like, about You can show it to your friends. You can get their feedbacks. You know, I would appreciate if everyone is so, you know, on their feet and said, here, I've shown it to 100 people and that's their feedback. You know, we should do this. We should do that. I will share my phone number. You can call me anytime you want. Any access that you want from us, we will be happy to give it to you. Because you guys are the future, right? And we want to make this future with you guys.
Samriddhi, let me just add one thing. You know, since there are a lot of questions around structure, roles, JD and stuff like that, right? You know, to all the students, I'll just say one thing, that the world is not what it was 5, 10, 15 years back, right? We are absolutely evolving at this point of time. I'm assuming a lot of you guys are management students, BBA students, and somebody's reading Philip Kotler. Do you think there was any social media or digital marketing platform when Philip Kotler was writing the marketing management book? There wasn't. You put him in the center of writing a book on digital marketing, he'll have to think like a student first before writing a book, right? And that is where we are as a world. So don't worry about structures. Don't worry about, set patterns, right? The work culture is going to be absolutely dynamic, fluid, ambiguous, and whatever, you know, in the similar space that a startup can offer. And that is the best part about, you guys getting involved in a platform like Fandrum at this point of time, right? Today, from my experience as a marketer, I have a lot of my colleagues and a lot of people who I interact with. Nobody wants to go to a traditional sector, right? Nobody wants to, as much as FMCG, for example, was the fascinating industry about 10, 15 years back. Today, nobody's seeing FMCG as the future industry where they want to grow their career, right? Everybody wants to be in the sunshine sector. Somebody wants to go in Ola, somebody wants to go in Swiggy, somebody in Zomato, somebody wants to go in startup, and somebody wants to, you know, launch their own startup. So be ready for a lot of dynamic working culture without worrying about role, designation, responsibility, what is my territory. Don't worry about that. One thing I'll just say that Samriddhi, I think, was trying to put across, that it's your passion. Be ready to get involved in everything. You are getting an opportunity to define your own working boundaries, whatever you want to get involved in. Just be the voice of that fan to the brand. Be a voice of the people who use the platform. Bring ideas from them to Fandrum platform rather than worrying about, you know, specific roles in JD. I mean, that's minuscule. Those things keep changing. Those things can evolve. How you set your own boundaries is up to you, to be honest.
That was very well said. And this is coming from ahead an entire channel. So guys, this is very, very important. Keep yourself dynamic. Keep yourself free. Don't get sucked in by this new thing about getting into JDs and everything. I was never a JD person. I never followed dynamics. I used to enter into every field that I could and learn as much as I could, you know. So that's where it helps. I'm taking lessons from Gaurav right now on because I want to learn marketing. So that is where it's helping, you know. Be hungry for education. Be hungry for learning. That's all that matters. Ask whoever you join from here on, ask for more and more work. Be the one saying, I want to take more initiative. That's what everybody values.
Thank you so much, Samriddhi ma'am, and thank you so much, Gaurav sir, for answering all the questions in such an elaborate manner. And thank you, Pramod sir, for not only recording the event, but pitching in here and asking some relevant questions, which I hope that the students must have got something out of it, and they must have understood what this app is about. And the most important thing, that is passion. So with those words, I would request Soumya to kindly take the session forward. Soumya.
Thank you, Ms. Samriddhi Kattal, ma'am, Mr. Vipul Chaubey, sir, and Mr. Gaurav Bajratia for such an
enlightenment. Thanks, Samriddhi, Vipul, Gaurav, and other members of Fandrum team for bringing such an innovative idea of connecting with the celebrities. I'm sure that this app will be the most sought after app among the students. It will also provide job opportunities to students. Really, session was very interesting and motivating to all. So thank you to all those who are there in the session. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Amri sir, for giving us this opportunity. And students, I hope you can grab everything that you get.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Amri sir, I would love to hear your feedback.
Yeah, sure, sure.
Now I would like to invite Dr. Seema to deliver the vote of thanks.
So, good afternoon to one and all present here. I think I'm happy, quite happy to be here as part of knowing something new. Whenever I come to media department, it's really, I'm so glad that, you know, lagta hai ki pehle kyun nahi kiya. And the words which you guys were talking about, that's definitely the new generation, you know, with the exposure which these guys are getting. So as a vote of thanks, as a ritual, I thank Professor Dr. Amri Saxena, Dean DME Media School, Dr. Sushmita Mala ma'am, head of the Department of Media, Dr. Krishna Pandey ma'am, she's also taking care of the placement cell, and Mr. Mohit, my colleagues, Mr. Pramod Pandey, Tina ma'am, and all the lovely students here. I would like to tell you that whatever Team Fandrum has conveyed or percolated across is just a part of the latest, as Mr. Gaurav rightly said, that Philip Kotler must not have imagined about, you know, making something like an organic organization. I'm organic organization behavioral professional. But yes, these concepts, I really wish that they were incorporated in all the companies which I have worked for previously and currently, of course. But yes, moving further, they get an opportunity to work in this organic organization wherein there are no boundaries. So I would like to tell my students here that you're quite blessed in this new modern era of Z millennials, which we call you, that you're getting exposures to the startups, as Samriddhi rightly said, that don't look at immediate gratification. A delayed gratification anyhow will bring you a lot of money, a lot of wealth, but look at something which you want as a passion to pursue. So I think Fandrum is the right platform to start with. And you guys are quite lucky to be a part of, you know, to be associated probably very soon. And I would also say, I mean, I don't know how it would be, that more and more sessions, as Mohit sir was telling you that we had overlapping of sessions. So my BBA students couldn't attend fully. They're like, it's become a sandwich kind of a thing which you said today. But definitely, I would look forward to have one session for them as well.
Ma'am, absolutely. Thank you so much. Whenever you want, we'd be happy to do a session, and we would be happy to show the app, because we were not able to demonstrate the app. I really wanted Amri sir and ma'am and everybody of you guys, professors, to see the app. It's something that as a student, I'm proud to share, because it's nothing more important for you, for a student, to share it with the faculty that they've studied under, right?
Correct. So, true. It's not all about that fan movie. It's all about all, like you said, in B grade and C grade cities, people don't have access to, you know, even going to Amitabh Bachchan or Shah Rukh Khan's ghar ke bahar khade hoke.
And are still 1% of what it is. You know?
True. Yeah.
People follow television is the biggest source of entertainment in India. There are bigger celebrities, bigger followers of television than one can imagine. So we are the power of television celebrities and the television viewing audience.
You know, that's how even Amitabh Bachchan has come down to KBC. So television is definitely powerful.
First it's television, then it is OTT, and then it is films, right? So everybody is trying to come on television. So we want to harness the power of real India.
Very true. Congratulate you, Team Fandrum here. Thank you so much. Thanks to the students.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much, sir. Can't thank you enough.
In DME, we believe in engagement and empowerment of students. And since the time this COVID-19 struck in 2020, we intensified this whole process.
For the education sector, it was a big challenge. At DME, our small dynamic team decided to take this challenge head on. We organize different kind of programs, different webinars, wherein the distinguished people from the industry and other walks of life, they are invited to interact with the students. We try to keep them engaged in taking out newsletter, writing stories, editing stories, and not only that, they make posters, they make cartoons, they write pieces for the newsletter.
Mentoring Cell at DNE is a very unique feature in the ecosystem of education. While the subject teachers forge the knowledge domain strongly, it is the mentors who reach out to students in difficult times. During pandemic, when our students faced loss of their loved ones, home isolation, and several other family issues, mentors ensured that students remain cheerful, lively, and stay connected with us.
We have ensured that our students are treated with compassion, warmth, and gentle touch. And it has been our endeavor to treat all the academic activities of our students, which includes PSDA, internal assignment, and various other curricular activities accordingly.
Research Cell also pays huge emphasis on interdisciplinary nature of research. In order to promote this, the research centers of the Research Cell were also motivated to join with each other and conduct research activities for students, faculty within DME and outside DME.
While the strong academics and great industry connect is building great lawyers, media persons and managers at DME, we at Mentoring Cell are enabling these future leaders to be compassionate, emotionally strong and resilient for any times to come.
We empower the students. All the schools of DME, they have their students' council. In DME Media School, this council is part. They organize the program themselves, they take their own decisions, and they mobilize the students for all the good cause.
Art has the power to unite and connect during the times of crisis. Bringing people together, sharing, soothing, and inspiring are powers of art, which have been made emphatically obvious by the DME Cultural Societies during the COVID-19 pandemic. By taking different innovative approaches in organizing various virtual competitions and events in which the students of DME have taken part with great enthusiasm and proved that DMEans are unstoppable.
Care with compassion is motto of DME. During Corona period, we were always with our students. Their well-being is primary for us. We take care of our students.
We met the expectations of the students, of the parents, and above all, of the industry. The placements this year were better than those of the previous years. DME is committed to supporting its students in all possible ways.